there used to be buildings on the top of the pen, and they're called snow sheds. And it was this idea that you put a train in there and keep the tracks from getting drifted over and back.
Okay.
The flopping shaft soon severed the air brake lines, and the accelerating goose could not be controlled by the hand brakes. The goose seemed eager to fly as it descended the 3% grade toward Trout Lake.
Wow, I can see it in my mind.
Finally, as the car slowed a bit on a level section near Trout Lake Water Tank, the passengers, including a small baby and the motorman, unloaded from the machine as it passed a convenient snowbank. The motorman rushed to a trackside phone box and called Mrs. Vera Belisle, the Ofer agent, to warn her that there was a wild goose on its way toward her hamlet. Mrs. Belisle saw the goose descending the high line at a fast pace, and watched as it sped across the grade crossing, past the frame depot, and out onto the Ofer Loop Bridge. She called Vance Junction to warn them that the unmanned goose was on the loose. You know where Vance Junction is.
Oh, you're right.
The Vance Junction section man calmly walked up grade a little ways and placed two wrecking chains across the rails. Then they stood back as the unoccupied goose came down the grade from Ames. The motor hit the first chain with a teeth-shattering thump, but did not derail or stop it. Upon hitting the second chain, the wheels locked and the machine came to a noisy halt. It's a wonder that the runaway goose did not join the birds on the twisting high line, smashed to bits on the rocks some 1,000 feet below.
Oh my God.